Hello, YouTube. As we last left off, Rajai Ma'ayal was doing business with Millie Haston here to get herself some fancy new clothes. She decided to take the nudist life, so she went ahead and sold her. Oh, I guess she didn't sell it, but she unequipped her clothes and just got some gloves and a belt. She is still very proud of her fur. And she's going to continue on her business adventures today, trying to become a world-famous skooma chemist. The day's still early, so she has plenty of time. Oh, I forgot, she doesn't have any money left. Well, there's one way to remedy this. So Ma'ayal has been pondering a few things. She knows she's g can make a business with alchemy, but she wants to know if there's any other way she can make money. She was pondering enchanting, or trying to take up life with a spear. She has already proven herself to be fairly useful and fairly good with it. Hello, friend. I am Istiridion. Welcome to Balmora. If you have a question, I'll be happy to answer it, or try anyway. And if it's just a little advice you'd like, that's fine too. I'll take some advice. The further from civilization you go, the worse the dangers, but there's exceptions to that rule. Ald Sotha is a short walk from Vivec, but only a 5-year veteran with a full kit ought to be peeking in that hole. And I hear there's a couple of spots in Vivec's sewers where you wouldn't send a team of ordinators, but it's your call. You see something you don't like, back out and find something else to do while you train and build your up your kit. Rajai decides she needs some spells. Specifically, she wants to temporarily make herself smarter. She doesn't want to be the smartest, like, smarter than the smartest person, but she does want to still be a wise and shrewd business lady. She decides a bound spear spell wouldn't be too bad for her either. Nor would Soul Trap. She's starting to see better deals or better equipment that she might be able to acquire. Particularly, she needs this journeyman's mortar and pestle mortar, but it's still outside of her price range. She goes ahead and does it, thinking, well, we might be able to haggle him down a little bit. And she was able to. She switches around her pockets. Figured might as well put the new item, take it out of her backpack, put it in one of her pockets so she can use it at a moment's notice. Seems like a useful thing. Seems she's got the knack of her old bartering skills back, although she's not having as easy of a time as she used to. Ajira is not taking too kindly to the multiple attempts to talk her down a dollar. Well, she managed to make a good bit of potions, although she was only able to salvage about 75 of the 130 that she started with, or 130 of potions worth of ingredients she started with. But that's still a fair bit of money, figuring how she that's approximately $2,000 worth of potions. Rajai Malal, how do I even pronounce that? Rajai Maial has decided, you know, she's learned quite a bit. It's about ready to sleep for a while. Get a couple hours rest. Look back on things. Where she came from, where she's currently at, and what all she's learned. And potentially where she plans to go in the future. The slug fell through the ground, it seems. She takes the time to reflect a little further. She decides she feels a little more lucky from all the potions that she succeeded to make. She's taken quite a bit of fall damage since the last time she's last done this, and she's been hit in combat, and she's definitely gotten a lot wiser from all the potion making. So she reflects. She still doesn't have a concrete answer where she wants to go or what she wants to do. At the moment, she just wants to be a successful businesswoman. She did decide, though, she wants to get a better spear for herself, and she got this nice spell, but the problem is how unreliable it would be to cast this at the start of every fight, figuring how she can't even get it to work. She thinks the shopkeep gave her a raw trade. But instead of being an asshole about things, she decided she's going to make the best of the things that she can. And she gets a quote for a special enchantment. She's going to need about $2,000 to make it, though. So, it's back to making money for her. Rajai Maial, Skooma Chemist of Elsewhere. She's starting to make some money. She's about $800. She almost has enough in potions to make her business successful. seems Azira has caught on to the application of this business and is actually offering less than what Rajai was originally offering or asking for. It's almost night, so Rajai decides to get a meal, make some potions really quick, and call it a night. This potions are starting to get a little bit more costly for $2 worth of ingredients. So Rajai decides to head back to Senyanin, get a nice night's rest. Unless there's some sort of corner club or inn. Council Club. They have rooms. Room door. Rajai is not happy with this. And she tries to hightail it out. She figures she is lucky to get away. She's going to pay off her dues in Sedyanin. She'd rather deal with the guards than a bunch of psychopathic maniacs who wouldn't let her sleep in a room's bed in an inn. But the cops don't seem to mind. Maybe the bounty's too low for them to notice. She is an honest woman, but she'd like to make some money so that she can pay them, make some money for the Empire. For Uriel Septim, the man that she sent her free. It's morning, so she has another potion. Decides to speak to her old friend Errol at the trade house. She gets a hammer. Figured her rusty old halberd probably needs a bit of sharpening. And offers him some potions. Errol gladly accepts the trade. For Rajai is a fair friend. Rajai only needs to gather about 500 more dollars, too. And her quest to get that enchantment made on her spear will be complete. Rajai has not forgotten about this man. But she luckily has been brewing these potions for a while. She's getting good at making them, so she has no problems this man wrecking her fatigue or her face, because she can heal it right up now with her potions, poultices, and salves. She's also a lot luckier and more combat experienced through fighting all the worms. She wonders if the consensus, or the, I don't know why I keep saying that, the census office will let her take up the murderous traitor's house, maybe for a fine, or let her at least pay for the deed. She's getting good. She's able to more readily read this man's moves, dodge him. He still lands some blows, but she feels she's starting to get even. And she finally gets him down. She's gonna cheap shot him like he did her on so many occasions. And she's okay with it, because she's starting to realize the only way you're gonna hit someone in hand-to-hand combat is if you knock them down. Otherwise, you're just gonna be hitting their fists, or they're gonna block it. She feels like she has learned quite a bit from this experience of fighting this man, and she hopes she learns yet even more. Foreign Gilneth. She will not forget this man's face. As much as she despises him, he has taught Rajai a great lesson in hand-to-hand combat. She is sad that they're at odds and that this man had a bad past. Starting to get to the point where it hits way more often. She got him with the right hook. Now she's just trying to scratch him. She realizes Foreign Gilneth's main flaw in his strategy is the fact that he runs while she walks in this combat. So he's wearing himself out while trying to not let her wear him out. And that's also the mistake she was previously making. She takes everything he has, but she decides, out of decency, she'll give him her old clothes. And he can keep his shoes. She figured, this is a good opportunity. It might not be the best clothes, but they have a memory associated with them. She reads a book. It's a great tale of a bard getting his way, getting a good deal. It's a pretty long book at that. She feels like she's gained quite a bit of knowledge from this experience, and decides it's a good time to take a nap. It's still early in the day, so being the honest lady she is, she decides she's going to go and talk to the guards and clear her name. But first, she wants to try to raise some money for the Empire so she doesn't have to serve hard jail time. But she forgot she already bought out Errol's entire stock, or got all his gold. She decides it's a good time to put this candlestick back, now that her eyes have finally adjusted. She actually goes ahead and gives back some of the food she took. Not the exact same types, but she feels a little bit of variety won't hurt these men. Because really, she stole all this food out of desperation. She wouldn't have done this normally. And she also figures this is a good time to give back the unused lockpick. Hopefully no one's missing it. And she donates a cup from Balmora. She goes ahead and clears her name, ashamed that she made that mistake. Speaks back to Socius Argala about the murder of Processus Vitellius. Surprisingly, he awarded me with 2.5 times the amount of money that she found on the tax collector's body. Although I suppose that shouldn't be too surprising. There wasn't any speech option for the house, so Rajai decides this might not be a bad place to call home. She'll do all she can to make it more homely. First things first. She needs to get some items in here. Maybe put this tankard she picked up in Balmora on the table. Reminder of all her good drinking days. She'll drink to that. She'll also go ahead and give Foreign Gilneth some of his items back. She held no grudge against this man. If anything, she respected him. And she makes her trip back to Balmora. She has to finish her enchantment. But first, she has to reorganize her pockets a little bit. She actually decides, rather than take the easy route there, she'll go ahead and adventure a little bit. She feels like she can hold her own. She is happy though. She finally got a house. She shouldn't be in such a rush, but she kind of wants to get back there. She saw a couple spells that she had her eye on. One said mark and one was recall. Two teleportation spells. She's not sure if she can master them, being, I think, mysticism spells, but she can give it a shot. Save her some money on the transport. She sees a rat in the distance and decides this might not be a bad option. Trying a little sneak. Try to get in close before going for the kill. And she's seen. She doesn't want to harm the local wildlife too much, but she is gonna have to defend herself, and she understands that. She comes across a beautiful view and wonders if there's anything she can do to be able to see maybe a little further, but there isn't. It's too foggy. She took a bit of a fall and almost died. She figures this is a good place to call rest. She's getting torn up a little bit by this Triceratong thing. The Kagoti. But she managed to get a soul gem out of it, or a common soul, petty soul. A pretty good petty soul at that. She figures she might use that. She might use that for one of her enchantments. Although she has no idea what she's going to use it for just yet. Master and Sukuna are out. Load and Lone. She thinks it's a beautiful sight, but she doesn't have too much time to admire the two moons of Tamriel, of Nern. So she moves on. She sees what looks to be some sort of wasteland trench. And there's these flying bird dragon things. She's not much a fan. She's heard stories about the dangers of the wildlife in Morrowind. So she just perseveres and pushes on. Trying not to give them too much mind. Maybe sneaking around some if she can. She sees a scrib. But those are fairly harmless, so she pushes past. Looking for any alchemy ingredients she might be able to monetize. Thank you. Well, she didn't make too much, but she did get to see some pretty beautiful sights. Khajiit is curious why there's chemtrails in Morrowind, where there are no planes. But she has no time to worry about such petty things. She just has to not die. She almost did, but she survived. She is a hardy cat. So she pushes on. Maybe she can make a potion that restores some of her health. She's starting to become quite the alchemist. Being a journeyman. Welcome is what it says in Daedric. She's starting to pick up the local lore and the local language. She looks for a good potion she might be able to use. Fortunately, she's just finding a lot of the potions she sold. But it seems Azira has had some business, has some money again. I'm looking for a healer, Gaudabir. It's fine. I decide this is a good point to make my better sword so maybe I don't get as busted up next time. I figure 10 casts would not be too bad. Twenty-nine seconds is probably more than enough time to dispatch an enemy, and even still, I have 10 tries of 29 seconds, so this seems like a good spell. The Damon Heimberger helper. She decides to heal the Damon Heimberger helper, but it's not damaged at all. Seems the enchant process might have healed it. She wonders what else she might be able to enchant. But it's all for naught. So she goes and sees if she has any items that she might be able to make a healing potion out of. She has the corkbub root. and then Marshmallow. So she decides to go ahead and make a potion. So we're gonna stop telling her how jacked up her face is currently. And since she still has some money left over, she figured this is a good time to get those spells, if they have them here, which they don't seem to. I have to apologize to Sharn Gra Muzgob for the interruptions, but it's something that can't wait. She gets a healing potion, figured it's probably worth the effort. She continues to look for the mark and recall spells that she had heard about. She found recall. She needs a quick way of getting to and from her new house in Sedyanin. She does decide to get some of the cork root bulbs though, figuring how she already has the ingredients to make it some more restore health potions, pretty cost-effectively too. Now she just needs to find the mark spell, and it doesn't seem to exist anywhere. So she decides to try one of the other mage guilds, figuring wizards probably know the spell somewhere. And she thinks she just found a better spot for her to make some money. Hearing how they stock more. It's a little bit more costly for her though. Instead of paying 12 for 10, she's paying 7. Or 7 each. Or not each. Instead of paying 12 for 10 potions worth of ingredients, she's paying 14. But she suspects she might be able to haggle. She is. She's going to try the 12 range that she's accustomed to. But this guy's not having any of it. She's getting a little better again at Hagelin. She found out if she gives people a break sometimes, they remember the good about her, the good business deals she offers, instead of the fact that she constantly haggles them down. And she just noticed that she bought way too many ingredients. She can't carry any of this. She's too heavy. So she decides to make some potions. And make those restore health potions while she's at it. That way, if she's ever in a jam, she can at least heal herself. Unsurprisingly, she's still over encumbered, but she should be able to work her way out of this one. Figures maybe a couple more and she can sell, get all the guy's money. 786. She's back to being able to walk around, although she does miss having her fur exposed. I'm proud Khajiit. She is still looking for other spells, though, so she decides she can give it some time and look for other spells aside from Mark, although recall without Mark is relatively pointless, since she can't set the waypoint. She decides to try a different mage's guild. She's actually gonna double check Balmora and make sure she didn't forget any. She sees all sorts of alchemical ingredients, but she assumes that they belong to the guild and she is not part of. She does find an interesting book on alchemy, though. Another long one. She does want to start a book collection, maybe someday, once she has enough money to be able to throw at it. Maybe that's one of her long-term goals. She shares a chuckle, noticing that none of the enchanters have an enchantment as good as hers. Hers allows for pretty much impervious or flawless weapons, because they almost never break. She also notices she has enough money for either a retort or a calcinator. Not the alembic, nor really anything else. She decides to go with the calcinator. It's cheap enough. Seems to be the first thing she always upgrades anyway. She's keeping her eye on the market, seeing what all she can find. She is getting quite good at alchemy. And she finally manages to find the spell she was looking for, or at least one of them. She's still missing that spell that makes her a little smarter. She needs it, at least for her alchemy purposes. She understands that some go mad with power with these spells, but she's going to make a weaker one. She strives not to have all the power in the world, just to be more powerful. Although she supposes it might be too close, too similar a thing. And one might lead into another, a gateway spell, if you will. She decides to visit her friend Errol and Sedyanine. Ariel might have something he needs, and she needs to mark her new house. She has learned quite a bit from this adventure. Ravir, she already likes him. So she gives him some money. Get sent back home to elsewhere to feed his kittens. And she actually manages to find a pretty good spear, but it doesn't stand up to the one that she made. Hers is still better. So she decides to give him some business. Revere's out here on his own, he needs some help too. She assumes 580 to be a good price for all the potions. She tells herself one of these days she'll get some of these books, but for now she decides an amulet and a ring wouldn't be a bad idea for her. She has to look nice. She also decides to get a couple lanterns and some candles for her house, make the place look nice. She is becoming a good enough businessman or businesswoman that she can start to really make money and stay afloat in this cruel world. It has been a while since she's eaten, and she's actually pretty hungry. So she drinks a few energy drinks and looks around, see if she can find any barterers, someone that she can put these potions off on. She decides the rest is probably best saved for Errol. He deserves the business anyways. She jumps off in a foolish endeavor and damages her leg. She decides to go home and rest off the swelling before paying a visit to Errol or Aril. I don't even know how to make this thing interesting for you guys, to be honest. I'm just kind of like talking. And then again, I think the first problem there is, I'm assuming, is there's you guys. There could be. As far as I know at the moment, I'm the only person that's actually watched the two videos I've made. And that's just because I wanted to make sure I didn't sound like too absurdly stupid. Probably do, but I don't really care. She decides to mark her house, as all good cats do. She marks it right on the bed. She might be at this a while. She wants to make sure that there's no way any intruders can have even a hint of ambiguity as to whose location this is. It's her house, so she's gonna make it most assuredly hers. She has an actual 5% chance of trying it. She's gonna try and mark in her house again. She might have to speak to the wizards and see how to cast this darn thing. She does finally manage to mark her house, specifically her bed. She decides this might not be a bad opportunity to practice her mysticism a little bit more. Because that's most certainly going to be a spell she's going to use a lot more. Just because, I mean, there's business applications to that. She can get home fast, it's convenient. She doesn't have to pay to get back here. Although she does have to pay to get here unless she takes the long route, which, based on the fact she has the probably most badass spear in the game, she doesn't see a problem with that. And she finally found the spell she was looking for. It came at a cost, though. It wasn't cheap. She decides she'll go ahead and pay a visit back to the tax collector. Poor man. She gets her spear out though in defense. You never know what could be lurking in those waters or on these hills. Unfortunately, in open Morrowind, compared to normal Morrowind, things don't seem to respawn yet. They're still working on that. I submitted a bug report. Other people have submitted bug reports. I wasn't the first one to do it. I didn't know there was already bug reports out there. Also, these things, like organic materials, aren't respawning yet, so I have to be a little wise with where I place things. She decides to give him $200. and memory. It's a good tribute she feels. The money that he was killed over. She looks again. Maybe there'll be a fish here today. But it doesn't seem like it. She does want a fish, though. She is a cat. She livens her house up a little bit. She figures this is a good time to store some of the excess that she has. She can get back here at a moment's notice, so if she ever needs something for a customer, she can get it for him. She is brainstorming, though. She has this cagote hide. Maybe if she mixed that with moon sugar, she might be able to not make skooma, but something fairly useful. Or maybe there's other ingredients that can do it as well. There we go. Okay, so she risks passing out from it, but she can make herself faster for about a minute. That should save her when she's doing the adventuring, or if she ever has to get away from sleeping in the wrong bed. She decides it's a good time to sleep for the night. She'll head out in the morning. I've played this game probably too much, I'd say. This game's a big part of my life for the past 10 years, and actually I finally beat it recently. It took me long enough to actually finish it. The problem was I kept doing the, I'm not sure what to call it. I'm going to call it just by itself, the Morrowind Syndrome. I'd start the game, I get halfway through the main quest, every time a little bit further, but every time I went to go back to it after quitting for a while, I wouldn't remember where I was or what I had to do, so I just restart. So I couldn't finish it. And then right after finals for college, I decided I'm gonna beat this game finally. Sat down. I did have to use a guide for like two quests. I feel ashamed of that, but now I can actually do those parts without it. I think that's the important part. Where Jai decides it's a good time to finally make the spell she was trying to make, or the spell she wanted. She's not going to go too crazy with it. I always put my custom spells with a space in the front of them, so that they're right on the top. I'd recommend any Morrowind players do that, because you can get way too many spells. Unfortunately, I just noticed my spear was created wrong. It has to be cast when used, which means I have to bookmark it like this. There we go. It's 2,400 for this. I'm going to talk her down to $680 for it. It's now potionless, but I didn't really go down too much in price. Or in gold. Still have some potions left. Where was that? Sadrith Mora, I think. This guy. It's almost time for Rajai to fall asleep again, rest, contemplate everything she's learned. She decides this is not a bad idea. So she goes ahead. Since she bought too much, she's going to go ahead and make her potion. Excuse Sorry about that, guys. It's currently like 11 o'clock. It's getting kind of late in real life for me. Not you guys, and not... Oh, I mean, I guess it could be you guys. I don't really know. So she decides she's going to try this spell. Although she has a very low chance of actually pulling it off. You have my attention. So now she needs to look for one other spell. I don't know why all the NPCs keep telling me why I shouldn't be here. Rajai has pretty much any right she wants to be here. I mean, if they don't want people in the Mages Guild, they shouldn't offer me to join it. Or for her to join it, I guess. She needs a drain spell, like a drain intelligence. Although, it looks like no one's having any of this. Welcome to you too, Azira. We love you. I've always wondered why these are giant fleas, but Michael Kirkbride. On occasion, I might have to open console to reset the Siltstrider people, because they run away, because they're idiots, but... Rajai is a little bit impatient and jumps off of everything. She could walk, but she's better at running. She's noticed, unfortunately, she hasn't been paying much attention to her combat skills. She figures probably a good time to focus on them. in Open Morrowind, there's currently a glitch, which I'm somewhat abusing, although you could still do it in vanilla Morrowind. It was just, it took longer. Where if you rest for 1 hour, 100% of the time you run into an enemy. They already know something's fishy with that, and they're working on it. So, Rajai needs to create a new halberd, a new spear or weapon. Because needing to cast this one kind of makes having the spear itself pointless. She does note, though, that technically for training purposes, this one is just as good due to its smaller hits. And Rajai has finally got to the point where she can finally recollect and have something tangible to look back on. That she's accomplished. She has a better idea of what it is she wants to do. She doesn't really want to work for anyone else. She wants to be her own boss. At the moment, she's laying down the groundwork for that, the framework. But eventually, she is going to want to be an adventurer. At least until she takes an arrow to the knee. Am I right, guys? Am I doing it right? And sorry for the pause, guys. I'm actually working on uploading the previous video onto YouTube right now. So I might be quiet for a minute. It got me. If you always use best attack, you actually make combat a hell of a lot easier. You get a lot of get rid of a lot of control. But you also make training harder. So, like I said, Rajai is not a dumb girl. She is a smart cat. Figures this is a good time. If any time is good, she's starting her business but hasn't consumed her life yet. She's gonna toughen up in case anyone tries to rob her. She runs into any bandits on the highways. Also, this is perfect for her business. It gives her fresh ingredients, alchemy, odds and ends. Thank you. Rajai does like the ocean, having that nearby. Sometimes there might be fish, and that's something that seems to be lacking out near Balmora. She does spy some clams out there, some oysters. She wonders if she can dive deep enough to get them. She thinks she sees a fish too. And I think the fish sees her, so she's gonna back away. She knows better than to fight them in their own territory. She's lucky, she might be able to run into a drow or two, The drow wax is a valuable alchemic ingredient. She just wishes she could sneak in the water, although it looks like she can, which might be a glitch or a bug. I might have to report that. And she's seen again. She's gonna go and eat one of those scales. She knows it's not good for her, but her instinct compels her to. She is worried she not may not make it to the bottom in time. So she backs back up. She's not quite as fast as she'd like to be. Especially not in the water. She is kind of heavy, so she decides before she goes and hunts clams, she might want to drop some things off at her house. Like I said, guys, I'm uploading the previous video and I do apologize for the brief break. On occasion, I have to hop over to my laptop. Maybe just type a few words here and there. I'll get it done eventually. Speaking of which, I think I've been playing this for at least over an hour. I might want to cut this one short and upload it because it's probably nearing a gigabyte, or probably nearing two now. And props to anyone that actually watches these. I mean, they're pretty freaking long. Most of it's me doing the nonsense. I am actually trying to make it a little bit faster. Like, for instance, I started directly with alchemy instead of doing the spear stuff, so I actually have money. Oh, and I jump everywhere instead of doing my previous walk because it's better for your fatigue. I'm not gonna do that to you guys. Decides it's a good place to drop off her goblet since she finally has a permanent place of residency. And also, It might not hurt for her to leave her heavy alchemy ingredients behind. Ideally, when she's out and about, potion or ingredient buying or gathering, she's trying to bring them back to her shop. She's not trying to make all of them in the same spot or in the out in the wild. That's going to allow her to move much faster. She does want at least one of these potions, though. Should do a couple of them. She decides she'll take the long way back to Balmora, but this time she has her speed potion, so she should be able to make it there a lot faster. And since she's already killed and cleared some of the enemies out, she should be good. She's starting to get a lot faster from her constant trekking, her battles. And she does notice she is awfully close to where Caldera should be. Did I get stuck? I got stuck. Unfortunately, I'm gonna have to do that on occasion. They have most of the bugs out, but they're still, like in Vivek City, I can still sometimes get stuck in walls. I still suggest open Morrowind over the original Morrowind engine, though. Their objective is to make it an improvement on what the original game was without really changing the gameplay, which I'm okay with. Once they start like Skywind, I'm not okay with Skywind, and neither is Rajal, Rajai, Rajai Ma'ayal. Stuck again. Most likely this thing looks like it's here, but it's not. It's slightly off. So, it's a problem with super ambitious games. I feel like there's something important here that I'm forgetting, right in this location. But oh well, I'm back in Balmora. I see the Silt Strider. I'm home free. I'm This says welcome, despite the fact that when you mouse over it, it says Belmora. Welcome. Same thing with over here. This actually, I already pointed this out. It's saying welcome. Unfortunately, Rajai needs to find a new spear, a new halberd. Because hers is essentially garbage. She'll hold on to it for the time being, but there's not really a whole lot she can do with it. She does decide she was going to find some medium armor, at the very least a shield. But all she can find is light armor. It's a sad day. She's decent with the medium armor, just not her preferred type. She'd prefer not getting hit at all instead of getting hit but not it not hurting as much. So now she has to look for a medium armor. I've always been a fan of the Drew shields, but they're pretty costly. She decides she can't really use boots, but she will get some pauldrons. And some bracers, as well as a shield. And she feels she can talk him down to about 570, still being reasonable. And she forgets why she came to Balmora. Oh, the halberd. She should still be able to buy a new actual, like, correctly enchanted one. She could try chancing it herself, and she might before spending this money. I mean, she is pretty lucky, and she's a pretty smart girl, just to make sure. She's going to boost her intelligence a little bit, but it barely works. She figures 29 seconds is easily more than enough. Aw, on self when strikes, everything should be good, and she hopes. She crosses her fingers, and it fails. So she tries again. She figures it's better to try than to waste her money. And it succeeds. So now she has a spear that she can be proud of. And if she can, she's gonna try a couple more. She is particularly lucky, after all. She needs a recall, but I don't think she has anything that would really be able to hold the enchantment. She crosses her fingers, and she fails. She only has one more try left at this. And she wasted it. But it's better than paying 10,000 for an enchantment. She figures she might as well just cast it herself. She hopes to find maybe a better spear, something that she can aspire to create, to enchant in the future. But unfortunately, all these Nords and Dark Elves seem to want is swords. She is eyeing the crossbow that they have, but she doesn't think that she'd even be that great of a shot. And those aren't really particularly good at keeping people away so much as killing them before they get to you. Whereas this, her spear, allows her to not only kill them before they get a chance to hit, but if they're close, keep them away while they're at it. She sees 53 Saltrice and Donia Rolal's inventory and figures that's a steal. She'd be stupid not to buy it. She is still keeping her eye on out for some Kagoti hide because she can really use that stuff. Unfortunately, the shopkeeper does not restock the Saltrice that she had. She figures it's best to get out of House Lalu. They're not necessarily good people. So she decides to recall for the night. She doesn't really have a whole lot of business left out in these parts. Unless she can manage to find a damage attribute spell, or drain attribute, rather. She'll keep her options open. But she has low expectations within the temple, who is mainly dedicated to healing, not damaging. The Om Sivi temples. I feel like there should be something here, but there's not. What is this about? Before heading in for the night, I'm gonna make Rajai Mayalal maybe dwell on her past one more time, see where she's going, take everything in. Rajai is not the best armorer, nor is she particularly all that strong. She's just a very fast, agile cat that everyone likes. And a lucky sumbitch, too. Being smart doesn't hurt, and with a little luck now and then is nice, but the key to patience is, the key is patience and hard work, and when that pays off, it's sweet! Level 11. Say, once you're level 20, you can do almost everything in this game. Although, if you focus on only alchemy, you can get to level 20 without having any combat experience. So that's not 100% true. I'm probably gonna call it a night, guys, and when I come back, when I post again, I guess, we'll continue the path of Rajai Myal. Rajai I could have chosen a better name for her. I didn't. So yeah, I'll see you guys later, and hopefully you enjoyed this. If you do, please like and subscribe. The only reason I'm gonna say that is because it helps me know that people actually watch this shit. Otherwise, I probably won't care eventually. Although I might. This is my favorite game, so I very well might post. But yeah, also if you have any tips for Morrowind beginners, please post that as well. My tips are usually different than everyone else's, because everyone else seems to say, well, do the main quest, do these things. For beginners, what made it such an experience for me was me not doing that. Me going out, me exploring, me creating a character and trying to live their lives. That was pretty amazing. I mean, everyone who's beat Morrowind has been Nerevarine, but has everyone who's played Morrowind been Rajai Myal? I probably not. But anyways, like and subscribe, or whatever, or downvote if you hate it. If you think my voice sounds stupid, or if I need to fix some audio issues, please let me know. I don't really care. Whatever. See you guys.